There are different ways to load data to autonomous transaction processing. If you have small volumes of data to load, you can load data via SQLNet. But if you have large volumes of data, the preferred technique is to load from files stored in a cloud-based object store, such as Oracle Object Storage or Amazon AWS S3. Let's find out how to upload data to Oracle Object Storage, and then copy this stage data into database tables in autonomous transaction processing. Start with uploading the data. Sign into Oracle Cloud Interface. Select Object Storage from the Storage menu. Create a bucket in a compartment of Oracle Object Storage. Click Upload Object to begin selection of the data files you want to upload to the bucket. Navigate to the location of the data files on your local computer. Drag and drop each file, or click Upload Object to upload each file. Here, the data files of the sales history tables from an Oracle sample schema uploaded. You can also use curl commands to upload large numbers of files. The data files are uploaded to the bucket. These files, staged to the cloud, are ready to be copied into the tables of your autonomous transaction processing database. To load data from an Oracle Cloud Infrastructure Object Storage Object Store, you will need to create an Auth token for your Object Store account. The communication between your autonomous transaction processing database and the Object Store relies on the Auth token and username password authentication. Click User Settings under your username on the Object Storage console. Click Auth Tokens under Resources on the left of the console. Click Generate Token. A pop-up dialog appears. Set the Auth token by performing the following steps. In the pop-up dialog, enter a description. Click the Generate Token button. Copy the generated token to a text file. It will not be shown again. Click Close. Next, store the credentials of the object store in the target schema of your autonomous transaction processing database. Open SQL Developer and connect to your autonomous transaction processing database as your target user. In a SQL Developer worksheet, use the Create Credential procedure of the DBMS Cloud package to store the object store credentials in your target user schema. Create a credential name. You will reference this credential name in the Copy Data procedure in the next step. Specify the credentials for your Oracle Data Infrastructure Object Storage service, the object storage username and Auth token generated in the previous step. After you run this script, your object store's credentials will be stored in your autonomous transaction processing user schema. In a SQL Developer worksheet, use the Copy Data procedure of the DBMS Cloud package to copy the data staged in your object store to your autonomous transaction processing user tables. For credential name, specify the name of the credential you defined. For file URI list, specify the URL that points to the location of the file staged in your object store. The URL is structured as follows, where you specify the region name, tenant name, bucket name, and file name. The data has been copied from the object store to the tables in your autonomous transaction processing database. All data load operations done using the PLSQL package DBMS Cloud are logged in two tables. The DBA load operations table shows all load operations. The user load operations table shows the load operations in your schema. This is a query on the user load operations table. It shows that 5 rows were loaded into the channels table with no failures. The log and bad files are accessible as tables. For detailed steps on performing the example shown in this video, go to the Oracle Learning Library and open the tutorial named Loading Your Data into Autonomous Transaction Processing. Find out more at cloud.oracle.com/ATP.